好，我们现在到新闻发布会的现场来看一下神舟十二号载人飞行任务的现场新闻发布会。
女士们、先生们、媒体朋友们，大家上午好。
Friends from the media, ladies and gentlemen, good morning.
昨天下午，空间站阶段飞行任务总指挥部召开会议，研究确定了神舟十二号载人飞船发射计划和航天员飞行乘组。今天我们邀请到中国载人航天工程办公室主任助理季启明向大家介绍任务有关情况，并回答媒体提问。我是主持人张哲。
The space station phase flight mission headquarters meeting was held yesterday afternoon. It was evaluated and confirmed the launch plan and crew members of Shenzhou 12 manned spaceship. Today, we have invited Mr. Ji Qiming, the Assistant Director General of China Manned Space Agency, to brief you about relevant information and take the questions you may have. I am the host, Zhang Zhe.
下面请季启明先生首先介绍这次任务的有关情况。
Now I will pass the floor to Mr. 季启明。
女士们、先生们、记者朋友们，上午好。受任务总指挥部委托，由我向大家介绍神舟十二号载人飞行任务有关情况。
My journalist friends, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. As commissioned by the mission headquarters, I take this chance to brief you about the Shenzhou 12 manned spaceflight mission.
经总指挥部研究决定，瞄准北京时间6月17日9时22分发射神舟十二号载人飞船。
As evaluated and decided by the mission headquarters, Shenzhou 12 spaceship is targeted to launch at 9:22 June 17th, Beijing time.
飞行乘组由航天员李海胜、刘伯明、汤洪波组成，李海胜担任指令长，备份航天员为翟志刚、王亚平、叶光富。
The crew members are 聂海胜、刘伯明 and 汤洪波 with 聂海胜 as the commander. Backup crew is composed of 翟志刚、王亚平 and 叶光富。
航天员李海胜参加过神舟六号、神舟十号载人航天飞行任务。航天员刘伯明参加过神舟七号载人航天飞行任务。航天员汤洪波是首次飞行。
聂海胜 has flown with Shenzhou 6 and Shenzhou 10 missions, 刘伯明 with Shenzhou 7 mission, and 汤洪波 will this time has his first space flight.
今天上午，执行此次发射任务的长征二号 F 遥十二火箭将加注推进剂。
This morning, the Long March 2F Y-12 launch vehicle set for the mission will be loaded with propellant.
神舟十二号载人飞行任务是空间站关键技术验证阶段第四次飞行任务，也是空间站阶段首次载人飞行任务。任务有以下主要目的。
Shenzhou 12 manned spaceflight is the fourth mission in the key technologies verification phase.Also, the first manned mission in the space station phase. Following main objectives are set for the mission.
在轨验证、航天员长期驻留、再生申报、空间物资补给、出舱活动、舱外操作、在轨维修等空间站建造和运营关键技术。
The verification of key technologies for the construction and operation of the space station.Such as astronaut long duration in orbit stay, regenerative environment control and life support, goods and materials resupplies, extravehicular activities, extravehicular operations, and in orbit maintenance.
首次检验东风着陆场的航天员搜索救援能力。
Test on the astronaut search and rescue capability for the Dongfeng landing site for the first time.
开展多领域的空间应用及实验。
Space application tests and experiments in multiple disciplines.
综合评估考核工程各系统执行空间站任务的功能和性能，进一步考核各系统间的匹配性和协调性，为后续任务积累经验。
Comprehensive assessment and evaluation on the functionality and performance of every system performing the space station mission, and a further examination on the level of compatibility and coordination between systems, as well as accumulation of experience for future missions.
按计划，神舟12号飞船入轨后，将采用自主快速交会对接模式，对接于天河核心舱的前向端口，与天河核心舱天舟二号货运飞船形成组合体。
As per schedule, Shenzhou 12 will conduct, after orbital injection, the rendezvous and docking in fast automated mode onto the front port of the Tianhe core module to form a complex together with the Tianhe core module and the Tianzhou 2 cargo ship.
航天员进驻核心舱，执行天地同步作息制度进行工作生活，驻留约三个月后搭乘飞船返回舱，返回东风着陆场。
The astronaut will then move into the core module to start working and living in orbit with synchronized work and rest arrangement between the space and the ground. After a duration of 3 months, astronaut will return to the Dongfeng landing site onboard the re-entry capsule.
目前，天河核心舱与天舟二号组合体状态稳定，各项设备工作正常，具备交会对接与航天员的进驻条件。
Currently, the Tianhe core module and the Tianzhou 2 cargo ship complex is in stable status, with all equipment functioning well, ready for the rendezvous and docking, and astronauts moving in.
执行神舟12号飞行任务的各系统已完成综合演练，航天员飞行乘组状态良好。发射前，各项准备已基本就绪。
All systems conducting Shenzhou 12 mission have undergone a comprehensive rehearsal. The flight crew is in good shape, and all the pre-launch preparations are in order.
以上是介绍的这次任务的有关情况。下面我愿意回答大家的提问。
The above briefing is the mission profile. Now I would like to take your questions.
下面我们请各位媒体朋友提问。提问前啊，请通报自己所在的新闻机构。
Now we would have the questions from the media, and please name yourself and your agency beforehand.
请第二排这位穿蓝色衣服的记者提问。
啊，谢谢，我是新华社记者。您刚才提到神舟十二号是中国空间站阶段的首次载人飞行任务，那请您简要介绍一下中国空间站建造任务的总体规划。作为空间站阶段的首次载人航天飞行，那么本次任务有何特点和意义？谢谢。
I'm with Xinhua News. You've just introduced the Shenzhou 12 spaceflight spaceship will be the first manned mission during the space station phase.Could you please briefly introduce the overall plan for the construction of China's space station, and what are the features and the significance of this mission?
谢谢新华社记者的提问。按照空间站建造任务规划呀，今明两年将实施11次飞行任务，包括三次空间站舱段的发射、四次货运飞船的发射和四次载人飞船的发射。
Thank you for your question. As per the construction plan of the China Space Station, altogether there will be 11 spaceflight missions in this and next year, including three space station modules, four cargo ships, and four manned spaceships.
2022年完成空间站的在轨建造，建成国家太空实验室，之后，空间站将进入到应用与发展阶段。
The space station will be assembled and completed in orbit by 2022 to serve as the National Space Laboratory, followed by the phase of application and development.
这十一次任务紧密关联，环环相扣。近期发射的天河核心舱与天舟二号货运飞船已形成组合体，在轨运行。
These 11 missions are closely related and connected. The recently launched Tianhe core module and Tianzhou 2 cargo ship is now operating in orbit as a complex.
神舟12号载人飞船发射入轨后，将与核心舱组合体进行交会对接。总体看啊，神舟12号飞行任务有以下四个方面的主要特点。
Shenzhou 12 spaceship will conduct rendezvous and docking with the core module complex when in orbit. In general, Shenzhou 12 mission possesses the following four features.
一是将进一步验证载人天地往返运输系统的功能和性能。
First, it will further verify the functions and performance of the manned space-to-Earth transportation system.
改进后的长征二号 F 运载火箭提高了可靠性和安全性。神舟十二号载人飞船新增了自主快速交会对接、镜像交会对接和180天在轨停靠能力，改进了返回技术，进一步提高落点精度，还将首次启用载人飞船应急救援模式。
The improved Long March 2F launch vehicle has enhanced its reliability and safety. The Shenzhou 12 spaceship is newly equipped with the capabilities of fast automated rendezvous and docking, radio rendezvous and docking, and 180-day on-orbit berthing. The return technology has been improved with the better accuracy of the landing point. The emergency rescue mode of manned spaceship will also be established for the first time.
第二是将全面验证航天员长期驻留的保障技术。
Second, it is to fully verify the technologies supporting astronauts' long-term presence in space.
通过神舟十二号航天员乘组在轨工作生活三个月，考核验证再生申报、空间站物资补给、航天员健康管理等。航天员长期太空飞行的各项保障技术。
It is by the three-month working and living of the Shenzhou 12 crew on orbit, long-term spaceflight supporting technologies such as regenerative environment control and life support, space station goods and material resupply, and astronaut health management will be assessed and verified.
三是将在轨验证航天员与机械臂共同完成出舱活动、舱外操作的能力。
Third, it is to verify in orbit the capabilities of the astronaut completing extravehicular activities in cooperation with the robotic arm and extravehicular operation.
航天员将在机械臂的支持下，首次开展较长时间的出舱活动，进行舱外的设备安装、维修维护等操作作业。
With the support of the robotic arm, the astronauts will carry out the extravehicular activities for relatively longer duration for the first time, and perform operations such as extravehicular installation, repair, and maintenance of equipment.
四是将首次检验东风着陆场的搜索回收能力。
Fourth, it is to test the search and recovery capability of the Dongfeng landing site for the first time.
着陆场从内蒙古四子王旗调整到东风着陆场，首次开启着陆场系统常态化应急待命搜救模式。
The landing site from Sizi Wang Banner, Inner Mongolia, is adjusted to the Dongfeng landing site. The normalized emergency standby search mode of the landing site system will be activated for the first time.
这些技术的突破和能力的验证，将为后续空间站建造及应用发展奠定坚实基础，积累宝贵经验。
Breakthroughs in the above technologies and verification of the capabilities will lay a solid groundwork for subsequent space station construction and application, and thus valuable experience is accumulated.
神舟十二号任务作为我国空间站建造阶段的首次载人飞行，承上启下，十分关键。
Shenzhou 12 missions is of great importance as it is the first manned mission for the construction of the space station, a connection between the previous and subsequent missions.
任务实施期间，恰逢党的百年华诞，工程全线注重从中国共产党百年历史，特别是从中国共产党领导下我国航天事业建设发展的辉煌历程中汲取经验力量，提振信心斗志，正在以高昂的精神状态紧张投入到任务的各项准备当中。
The mission period coincides with the Communist Party of China centennial birthday, the century-long history of CPC, and the glorious cause of China's space career under the CPC leadership are sources for all sectors of the program team to absorb experience and strength, to boost confidence and will, and engage themselves in positive spirit with the preparation of Shenzhou 12 mission.
谢谢。
Thank you.
好，下面还有哪位记者提问？左边这位穿白色衣服的女记者。
谢谢主持人。您好，我是人民日报社记者。我的问题是，距离上一次载人飞行已有近五年时间，请问此次神舟十二号飞行中航天员的主要任务有哪些？他们为此都做了哪些准备？谢谢。
I'm with People's Daily. It has been 5 years since the last manned space flight mission. And what are the main tasks for Shenzhou 12 crew during the space flight? And how have they prepared for this mission?
谢谢您的提问。根据任务安排，神舟十二号飞行中，航天员乘组将在轨完成四个方面的主要工作。
Thank you for your question. As per the mission arrangement, the crew will complete 4 main tasks in orbit during the Shenzhou 12 space flight.
一是要开展核心舱组合体的日常管理工作。
First, it is to carry out the daily management of the core module complex.
包括天和核心舱在轨测试、再生申报系统的验证、机械臂测试与操作训练，以及物资与废弃物的管理等等。
Tasks include 天和 module on orbit test, regenerative environment control and life support system verification,robotic arm test and operation training, and goods, materials, and waste management.
第二是要开展出舱活动及舱外作业。
Second, it is to carry out the extravehicular activities and extravehicular operation.
包括舱外服的在轨转移、组装、测试，进行两次出舱活动。开展舱外工具箱的安装、全景摄像机抬升和扩展泵组的安装等方面的工作。
Tasks include the on-orbit transfer, assembly, and testing of the extravehicular spacesuits, twice extravehicular activities, assembly of the extravehicular toolbox, lifting of the panoramic camera, and installation of the extended pump set.
三是要开展空间科学实验和技术实验。
Third, it is to carry out space science experiments and technical tests.
进行空间应用任务、实验设备的组装和测试，按程序开展空间应用、航天医学领域等实验以及有关科普教育活动。
Tasks include the assembly and testing of experimental equipment for space application and execution of space applications, space medical experiments and tests as per schedule, as well as related public outreach activity.
四是要进行航天员自身的健康管理。
Fourth, it is to conduct health management of the astronaut.
按计划开展日常的生活照料、身体锻炼、定期监测维持与评估自身的健康状态。
Tasks include daily life care, physical exercises, regular monitoring, maintain and evaluate their own health status as per plan.
五年来，根据空间站阶段的任务特点要求，开展了航天员乘组选拔和针对性的训练工作。
In response to the features and requirements of the space station mission, crew selection and dedicated training have been carried out for the past 5 years.
本次任务航天员乘组选拔采用新老搭配、以老带新的方式，结合航天员的飞行经历、相互协同能力等方面，选拔出飞行乘组和备份航天员。
This mission crew is selected in line with the principle of mixing the old and the new, with the new being supported by the old. Mission crew and backup crew are selected in light of flight experience and mutual coordination capabilities.
周密制定了航天员训练方案和计划，扎实开展了地面训练和任务准备，每名航天员训练均超过了6000学时。
A training plan was carefully formulated. Solid ground training and the mission preparation were carried out. Each astronaut has received training for more than 6,000 class hours.
特别是针对空间站技术、出舱活动、机械臂的操控、心理以及在轨的工作生活，开展了重点训练。目前，航天员乘组已做好了执行任务的各项准备。
Dedicated training on space station technologies, extravehicular activities, robotic arm operation control, psychology, and on-orbit working and living were carried out. Now the flight crew is ready for the mission.
谢谢。
Thank you.
好，还有哪位记者提问？好，第一排这位女记者。
谢谢，我是中央广播电视总台的记者。那么我的问题是，现在在太空当中的天河核心舱和天舟二号货运飞船所形成的组合体现在的运行状态如何？还有就是组合体将为首批进驻的航天员乘组的工作和生活提供什么样的保障条件？谢谢。
I'm with CCTV News. What is the current status of the 天河 core module and the 天舟 2 cargo ship complex?What support conditions are provided for work and the life of the crew?
谢谢总台这位记者的关注。天河核心舱与天舟二号货运飞船入轨以后啊，已按计划完成了9类42项的测试，主要包括平台的基本功能、交会对接、航天员驻留、机械臂爬行与在轨辨识、出舱功能以及科学实验机柜等测试内容。
Thank you for your attention for the program. After Tianhe Core Module and the Tianzhou 2 cargo ship reached orbit, tests of 42 items in 9 categories were performed, including platform basic functions, rendezvous and docking, astronaut presence, robotic arm crawling and on-orbit edification, extravehicular function and scientific experiment racks.
截至今天，天河核心舱与天舟二号组合体已在轨运行17天，目前状态良好，平台设备工作正常，组合体已调整到高度约390公里的近缘对接轨道，建立起交会对接姿态和载人环境。
As of today,The Tianhe Core Module and the Tianzhou 2 Complex have operated in orbit for 17 days and are in good condition with the platform equipment working normally. The complex has been adjusted to a nearly circular docking orbit at an altitude of about 390 kilometers, establishing a rendezvous and docking attitude and manned environment.
经分析确认，组合体满足与神舟十二号交会对接以及航天员进驻的条件。
The analysis confirmed that the complex meets the requirements for the rendezvous and docking when Shenzhou 12 and for astronauts to move in.
天河恒星舱提供了三倍于天宫二号空间实验室的航天员活动空间，配备了三个独立的卧室和一个卫生间，保证航天员日常的生活起居。
The core module provides three times the space for astronauts compared with Tiangong 2 Space Laboratory. It is equipped with three separate bedrooms and one bathroom to ensure the daily life of the astronauts.
航天食品方面，配置了120余种营养均衡、品种丰富、口感良好、保质期长的航天食品。
In terms of space food, over 120 kinds of food are available with balanced nutrition, rich variety, good taste, and a long shelf life.
就餐区域啊，配置了食品加热、冷藏及饮水设备，还有折叠桌，方便航天员就餐。
The dining area is equipped with food heating, refrigeration, drinking water equipment, and folded tables to facilitate astronauts dining.
锻炼区配备有太空跑台、太空自行车等锻炼设备，用于航天员的日常锻炼。
The exercise area is equipped with exercising facilities, including space treadmills and space bicycles for astronauts' daily exercise.
通过天地通信链路和视频通话设备，可实现空间站与地面的双向视频通话和收发电子邮件。
Through the space-to-ground communication link and the video call equipment, two-way video calls between the space station and the ground and sending and receiving emails can be realized.
载人环境控制方面，相比前期载人飞行任务，空间站恒星舱配置了再生式的生命保障系统。
In terms of manned environment control, as compared with previous manned missions, the core module is equipped with a regenerative life support system.
包括电解制氧、冷凝水收集与处理、尿处理、二氧化碳去除以及微量有害气体去除等子系统，能够实现水等消耗性资源的循环利用，保障航天员长期在轨驻留。
The system includes several subsystems such as electrolytic oxygen, condensate water collection and disposal, urine disposal, carbon dioxide removal, and the removal of harmful trace gases. The recycled use of consumable resources like water can be achieved to ensure the long-term stay of the astronaut in orbit.
谢谢。
Thank you.
好，还有哪位记者？我们找一位外国记者，那位第一排穿蓝色西装那位。
你好，我是俄通塔斯社记者。请介绍一下中国载人航天国际合作的有关情况。未来中国是否会邀请俄罗斯和其他国家参加空间站上的科学研究、技术试验等工作？是否会有俄罗斯和其他国家航天员与中国航天员一起在中国空间站执行任务？谢谢。
I'm with TASS News Agency from Russia. Could you please briefly introduce the international cooperation of China's human space flight? In the future, will China invite other countries, including Russia, to participate in scientific research and technological tests on board the space station? will astronauts, including Russian astronauts, fly with Chinese crew on the China space station in the future?
谢谢塔斯社的这位记者的提问。外层空间啊，是全人类人民的共同财富，探索宇宙是全人类共同的事业。
The outer space is the commonwealth of people all over the world, and exploring the universe is the shared cause of all mankind.
中国载人航天始终按照和平利用、平等互利、共同发展的原则，愿意与世界上所有致力于和平利用外空的国家和地区一道，开展国际合作和交流。
Chinese human spaceflight is consistent with the principle of peaceful use, equality, mutual benefit, and common development. And we are willing to carry out international cooperation and exchanges with all countries and regions worldwide that are committed to the peaceful use of the outer space.
工程自立项实施以来，在航天器技术、空间科学实验、航天员选拔训练等领域，与俄罗斯、德国、法国、比利时、意大利等国家的航天机构，以及联合国外空司、欧空局等国际组织，开展了广泛的合作与交流。
Ever since the approval and implementation of the program, extensive cooperation and exchanges have been carried out with national space agencies from countries such as Russia, Germany, France, Belgium, and Italy, and international organizations such as the United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs and the European Space Agency. In the fields of spacecraft technology,space science experiments, and astronaut selection and training.
进入到空间站阶段，我们将继续加大国际合作与交流的深度与广度。
Right now, we are in the space station phase. We will continue to enhance the depth and the breadth of international cooperation and exchanges.
计划在空间站的功能拓展、空间科学应用、中外航天员联合飞行、技术成果转化等领域，开展更加广泛深入的国际合作，使中国空间站成为一个造福全人类的太空实验室。
It is planned to carry out more extensive and in-depth international cooperation in the fields of space station function expansion, space science and application, joint flight of Chinese and foreign astronauts.And the transformation of technological achievements so as to build the China space station into a space laboratory that will benefit the mankind.
为此，中国空间站已做好了相关准备，并开展了相应的工作。
To this end, the China space station has made corresponding preparations and has started related work.
比如配置在核心舱和试验舱上的科学机柜均配备了标准化的载荷接口，具备开展各类科学实验、国际合作的能力。
To this end, the China Space Station has made corresponding preparations and has started related work. For example, the scientific racks currently configured in the core and experiment modules are equipped with standardized payload interfaces, able to carry out international cooperation in multiple types of scientific experiments.
2016年以来，我们与联合国外空司合作，面向所有联合国的成员国，征集有意搭载到中国空间站合作的试验项目。
Ever since the year 2012, cooperation with the United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs was started. We are soliciting space experiment projects from all UN member states to aboard the China Space Station.
目前啊，已遴选出来自17个国家的9个项目，后续我们还将与联合国外空司紧密合作，实时发布第二轮合作机会的公告。
So far, 9 projects from 17 countries have been selected. In the future, we will work closely with the United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs to release the second round of announcement of opportunities in due course.
同时，我们还正在与法国、意大利、巴基斯坦等国家围绕在空间站开展基础物理、航天医学、空间天文等领域的空间实验进行了良好的双边合作交流。
At the same time, we are also having bilateral cooperation and exchanges with countries including France, Italy, Pakistan, and others, focusing on space experiments in fundamental physics, space medicine, and space astronomy on the space station.
中国和俄罗斯在载人航天领域一直保持着良好的合作关系，曾经开展了多项富有成果的合作。
China and Russia has always maintained a good cooperative relationship in the field of human spaceflight, with a great number of fruitful cooperation achievements.
在现阶段，双方围绕近地轨道空间站和载人升空探测领域，一直也保持着良好的交流，正在沟通酝酿，开展更多的合作项目。
At this stage, the two sides have maintained good exchanges in the low Earth orbit space station and manned deep space exploration, and are communicating for more cooperation to be carried out.
我相信在不久的将来，将会共同实施更多的联合实验项目，为人类探索外空做出两个航天大国应有的贡献。
I believe that in the near future, more joint experimental projects will be implemented to make due contribution as two major space countries in the exploration of outer space for mankind.
至于中外航天员的联合飞行，已经有不少国家和地区向我们提出了合作的意愿。对此啊，总体上我们持欢迎的态度，相信在中国空间站建成后，也就是不久的将来，我们将会看到中外航天员联合参加中国空间站的飞行。
As for the joint flight of Chinese and foreign astronauts, we have heard from a number of countries and regions with cooperation willingness, to which, in general, we take a welcoming attitude. It is believed that in the near future, when the China space station is complete,we will see more joint flights of Chinese and foreign astronauts.
谢谢。
Thank you.
好，还有哪位记者？那位穿长征运载火箭蓝色 T 恤的男记者。
好，谢谢主持人。中国日报记者提问，我的问题是：进入空间站建设阶段，载人航天的发射和返回任务呢，将保持常态化和高密度。那么与此同时呢，外界对于运载火箭末级残骸以及这个进入寿命期末期的载人飞船的载入问题也比较关注。那么请问咱们载人航天工程对此有何安排？谢谢。
I'm with China Daily, and now we are in the space station phase, and human space flight launch and return missions will become highly frequent and normal events. The world is paying close attention to the re-entryof the last stage of the launch vehicle and the end-of-life manned spacecraft. What arrangements have you made for this?
谢谢您对这个问题的关注。我国政府一贯致力于和平利用太空，愿与有关各方一道，为促进和平利用外空、维护外空安全做出共同的努力。
Thank you for your attention on this problem.On this aspect, the Chinese government has always been committed to the peaceful use of the outer space and is willing to make joint efforts with all parties concerned to promote the peaceful use and safeguard the security of the outer space.
我们愿意同各国就人造航天器的残骸、空间碎片问题开展更广泛的国际交流合作，确保外空活动的长期可持续性。
We are willing to conduct more extensive international exchanges and cooperation with other countries on the issues of man-made spacecraft wreckage and space debris to ensure the long-term sustainability of outer space activities.
运载火箭的末级经过轨道高度的自然衰减，最终载入大气层销毁，是目前国际上的一种通行做法。
The last stage of the launch vehicle passes through orbital altitude with the natural decay and falls into the atmosphere for destruction. And this is the current international practice.
执行空间站任务的各型火箭的末级均已采用了钝化技术处理，不会在轨道上发生爆炸而产生空间碎片。
The last stages of all types of launchers that perform the space station missions have been treated with passivation technology and will not explode in orbit and generate space debris.
火箭末级绝大部分组件将在载入大气层过程中烧蚀销毁，对航空活动及地面造成危害的概率极低。
Most of the components of the last stage will be ablated and destroyed during re-entry into the atmosphere, and the probability of causing harm to aviation activities and the ground is extremely low.
前期长征5号 B 遥2火箭和长征7号遥3火箭发射后，我们密切关注火箭末级的载入情况，组织进行了严密的监测。
We have paid close attention to the re-entry situation of the last stages of Long March 5B Y2 launch vehicle and Long March 7 Y3 launch vehicle after their launch and carried out rigorous monitoring.
在载人航天工程官方网站定期对外发布火箭末级的轨道参数，及时发布了长征5号 B 遥2火箭和长征7号遥3火箭末级残骸的载入时间和落点预告，履行了相关国际义务。
We have released on a regular basis the orbital parameters of the last stage of the launcher on the official website of Chinese manned space and announced in a timely manner the re-entry time and landing point of Long March 5B Y2 and Long March 7 Y3 last stage in fulfillment of international obligations.
天舟货运飞船在完成预定任务后将受控离轨载入大气层销毁，极少量的残骸陨落在南太平洋海域。
The Tianzhou cargo ship will deorbit and re-enter the atmosphere for destruction when all preset tasks are completed in a controlled manner, with only minimum wreckage falling into the South Pacific waters.
神舟载人飞船的推进舱与轨道舱在载入大气层时也将消失销毁，不会对地面造成危害。
The propulsion module and orbital module of the Shenzhou manned ship will be ablated and destroyed when re-entering the atmosphere and cause no harm to the ground.
谢谢。
Thank you.
好，我们最后一个提问机会，不知道现场有没有来自中国香港或者澳门地区的媒体记者？哎，那位是吗？啊，那位女记者啊。
谢谢。香港大公文汇传媒记者，我的问题是：中国空间站建设的目的是什么？与这个早期的国外的空间站和国际空间站相比，有什么特点和亮点？谢谢。
I'm with Hong Kong 大公文汇 Media. What is the purpose of China's building of its own space station? Compared with the early foreign space stations and the current international space station.What are the features and highlights of China's space station?
谢谢香港这位记者的提问。习近平总书记指出啊，探索浩瀚宇宙，发展航天事业，建设航天强国，是我们不懈追求的航天梦。
Thank you for your question. As pointed out by Secretary General Xi Jinping, exploring the vast universe, developing space activities, and building a powerful space nation is our unremitting space dream.
载人航天是人类航天活动中系统最为复杂、难度最大、要求最严的一项系统工程。
Human spaceflight activity is one of the most complex, challenging, and demanding system engineering in human space activities.
早在1992年，中国政府就制定了载人航天工程三步走的发展战略，建成空间站是发展战略的重要目标。
As early as in 1992, the Chinese government formulated a three-step development strategy for human spaceflight program. The completion of the space station is an important goal of this strategy.
在突破载人天地往返、空间出舱活动、交会对接、推进剂的在轨补加等一系列载人航天关键技术的基础上，经过十年的攻关研制，空间站已进入到在轨组装建造阶段。
On the basis of a series of key technologies for human spaceflight, including the breakthroughs in manned space-to-ground travel, extravehicular activities, rendezvous and docking, and propellant refueling in orbit, after 10 years of research and development, we have now come to the phase of on-orbit assembly and construction of the space station.
可以说，建设和运营空间站是衡量一个国家经济、科技和综合国力的重要标志。
It can be considered that the construction and operation of the space station is an important symbol measuring a country's economic, technological, and comprehensive strength.
在近地轨道建造和运营空间站，可以长期开展有人参与的大规模的空间科学实验和技术实验，能够极大地促进空间科学、生命科学等空间技术的发展，辐射带动相关领域的技术创新。
The construction and operation of space station in low Earth orbit can support long-term, human-tended, large-scale space science experiments and technological tests, which will greatly promote the development and progress of space science, life science, and other space technologies.Leverage and enable technological innovation in related field.
中国空间站的建造运营将为人类开展深空探索储备技术、积累经验，是中国为人类探索宇宙奥秘、和平利用外太空、推动构建人类命运共同体做出的积极贡献。
The construction and operation of China's space station will reserve technologies and accumulate experience for all the people. It is a positive contribution by China for humans' exploration of the universe, peaceful utilization of the outer space, and push forward the building of a community of shared future for mankind.
中国空间站建设起步相对较晚。但也有后发优势。
The construction of China's space station is relatively late, but with latecomer advantages.
在论证、设计和建造过程中，我们贯彻新发展理念，坚持独立自主、以人为本、兼容并蓄、持续发展，体现了鲜明的中国特色和时代特征。
In the process of the feasibility study, design, and construction, we have been consistent with the new concept of development, adhering to features of independent and self-reliant, people-oriented, inclusive, and sustainable, reflecting distinctive characteristics of China and the times.
总体看，中国空间站功能齐全，技术先进，规模适度。在可靠性、安全性、 舒适宜居性、综合效能、兼容拓展以及信息、能源、动力技术和运营的费效比等方面具有显著的优势。
In general, China's space station is equipped with complete functions, advanced technologies, and with moderate scale. It possesses remarkable advantages in the aspect of reliability, safety, habitability, comprehensive efficacy, inclusiveness, and scalability, as well as in information, energy, power technology, and operation cost-effectiveness ratio.
在空间应用方面，有望取得若干具有重大价值的科学发现和技术创新成果。
There are great perspectives in scientific discoveries and technological innovation outcomes of great value in the space application domain.
谢谢。
Thank you.
由于时间的关系啊，这次我们新闻发布会就到这里。感谢季启明主任助理的介绍和回答。随着空间站任务的后续开展，我们会持续通过新闻媒体和载人航天工程官网发布任务相关情况。也感谢大家对中国载人航天工程的关注和支持，谢谢大家。
Due to time constraints, the press briefing now comes to an end. Thank you, Mr. Ji Qingming, for your introduction and answers. As the space station missions progresses,we will continue to keep you posted and briefed by way of news media and the official website of China Manned Space. Thank you for your interest and support to China Human Spaceflight. Thank you.
好，咱们的新闻发布会呢到此告一段落。咱们信息量很大呀，大家关注的点包括神舟飞船这次的任务，包括航天员的乘组，还有接下来他们要去怎么样展开空间合作。咱们首先来认识一下这次的这个十二号这个任务，神舟十二号任务飞行乘组的相关名单。
嗯，
好。
其实呢，我们看到真的还是一个以老带新的这个组合，
对，
对吧？跟大家之前的这个猜测呢是一致的。只是最后亮相的这三名航天员呢，确实有的是大家非常熟悉的，
比如说聂海胜，这是第三次了。
聂海胜是对第三次了，
第三次了
啊。如果这次这个登上太空以后呢，就和齐海鹏一样了，
都是
三次登上太空，因为它是神六和神十任务。因为大家可能还记得，因为刚才我们还说到聂海胜了，对吧？
对。
因为神五的时候，我采访这个翟志刚和聂海胜的时候，当时他们可能也看出来了，充满期待，说神五虽然是这个备份的航天员哈，但是呢，很快我们看到神六，当时费俊龙、聂海胜就这个登上了太空。神十任务的时候呢，当时这个聂海胜就担任指令长了，
嗯。
而且呢，在这个神十任务之前呢，2011年他是被授予了少将军衔，所以其实也有一些说法说这个相当于聂海胜是。第一名登上太空的中国的这个将军呢，
将军对
哈，少
将军。而这次他的心情肯定不一样，
嗯，
因为他以老带新的话，这次他可能说要完成指令长的任务的同时，
对，
还要带这个第一次上去，也是咱们这个第二批入选的汤洪波，这是一位新人哈。
对，因为之前我们看到很多航天员，大部分都是60后，
对
啊，因为我们第一批航天员选拔很多都是从这个飞行员当中选拔出来的，
对，战斗机飞行员选拔
出来，对对对，所以呢，大部分都是60后。
嗯、
这次汤洪波我们看到是这个70后，但是之前女航天员我们这。有70后，
对
啊，但是这次呢是这个70后的这个汤洪波，
嗯
啊，之后大家可能会马上，我觉得这个媒体应该这个铺天盖地的这个报道应该就有了，更多的可能会有一些这个了解。但是我们刚才也说到了，他和这个聂海胜还有刘伯明不一样，
嗯，
因为呢刘伯明和这个聂海胜他们都是执行过任务的，
嗯
啊，所以呢，作为这个汤洪波来讲呢，他是第二批入选的航天员，和第一批入选的航天员呢，其实他们一直在训练了很多年，十多年了，
配合也。非常有默契，其实这样的一个配合也是一个传帮带的一个过程、
啊、而且刘伯明大家应该也很熟悉，对吧、
嗯、
神七任务的时候，因为是中国第一次这个舱外行走，
对、
我还很印象很深的就是他在这个轨道舱当时协助翟志刚出舱，所以那个画面其实呢也很
印象非常深刻、
嗯、大家还记得这当时那个拉舱门 对吧，
对，那一刻
第一下那个没拉开，我们在直播的时候当时感觉
心里边揪了一下，
心里很紧张，
对
对，后来就是在这个刘伯明的这个协助之下，当时翟志刚呢完成了这个出
舱，
所以印象很深刻。
对，
是一个老带新的这个组合。
对，那咱们来介绍一下他们相关的简历吧。咱们看一下，首先咱们提到的就是聂海胜啊，男，汉族，籍贯呢是湖北枣阳，中共党员，博士学位，1964年9月出生，1983年6月入伍，1986年12月加入中国共产党。 2014年6月任中国人民解放军航天员大队大队长，现为航天员大队特级航天员，专业技术少将军衔，曾任空军航空兵某师某团司令部领航主任，安全飞行1480小时，被评为空军一级飞行员。1998年1月入选我国首批航天员，2003年9月入选神舟五号飞行任务备份航天员，2005年10月执行神舟六号飞行任务，同年11月被中共中央国务院中央军委授予英雄航天员荣誉称号，并获航天功勋奖章。2008年5月入选神舟七号飞行任务的备份航天员，2012年3月入选神舟九号飞行任务备份航天员，2013年6月执行神舟十号飞行任务，担任指令长。同年7月被中共中央国务院中央军委授予二级航天功勋奖章，2019年12月入选神舟十二号飞行任务乘组，担任指令长。刘伯明，男，汉族，籍贯黑龙江伊安，中共党员，硕士学位，1966年9月出生，1985年6月入伍，1990年9月加入中国共产党，现为中国人民解放军航天员大队特级航天员少将军衔，曾担任空军航空兵某师某团中队长，安全飞行1050小时，被评为空军一级飞行员。好，我们再来看下一位，下一位也是我们这次新入选的，是汤洪波，男，汉族，籍贯湖南湘潭，中共党员，硕士学位，1975年10月出生，1995年9月入伍，1997年4月加入中国共产党，现为中国人民解放军航天员大队二级航天员大校军衔，曾担任空军航空兵某师某团大队长，安全飞行1159小时，被评为空军一级飞行员。好，我们看到这次呢，咱们还是传统的以老带新的模式啊，而且呢，我们看到航天员这次也提到了要有多次比较频繁的这个出舱活动，那对于他们来说有很高的要求啊，
而且是两次出舱活动。
对，
我们刚才看到在发布会上呢，其实也做了一个介绍，那么这次呢有几个方面的这个任务，刚才也都谈到了，那么第一个方面就是核心舱这个组合体，我们严博士其实也看到了，虽然呢现在这个问天和梦天呢还没有发射，没有对接，现在还不是一个 T 字形的结构，现在可以把它当成一个一字形，或者是加上这个太阳能帆板以后是一个工字形的结构。那么围绕这样的一个结构呢，我们看到航天员呢在3个多月的时间里要完成2次出舱行走，包括整个核心舱的一些这种设备的这个维护啊，轨道的这种测试啊，声保系统的管理等等，
要求都非常的高，
要求非常。
我们通过个短片来了解一下详细情况。
好，
5、4、3、2、1。点火，
点火，起飞，机龄1102:0315秒613毫秒。继续走吧，文昌光学雷达都正常，助力器关机，助力器分离。好，点得到。
我宣布，空间站天河核心舱发射任务获得圆满成功。